Hello. Well, it's tough to go live on Facebook when you have three dogs and people walking around on this beautiful day. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get started, and I'm going to apologize up front if we start having some loud noises, but that's part of the fun of working from home, right? Being able to have some animals go live and just kind of see what happens. So today what I'm going to do is talk about a great question that I got from my friend Sarah Nicoli about using Facebook photo albums in your Facebook strategy for your business. And Facebook photo albums are a great way to demonstrate a story or a series of images, and also to come back and reuse those things over time. And the question that Sarah asked was, how do I set up a photo album so that I can use those images in other posts and maybe even across other social media platforms without it immediately going through on the newsfeed? And that is a great question, because the photo album can be used in a very strategic way, but maybe you want to get it set up perfectly first. Maybe you don't quite have all the images there yet, but you want to set it up so that you can see basically the foundation of it and decide how you're going to craft it to use it later in a Facebook post or somewhere else across social media. One of the things I was also going to do today was, for the first time, use Facebook Live screen share. So something that's really cool about Facebook Live is that recently, I think late last year, not too long ago, it added a feature where you could screen share. And I've done it, well, I've tested it out where you start it right off with the Facebook Live, but I have not done it where I start the Facebook Live and then jump into it. So I was going to walk through this example, and I'm going to try something here because now I've gone live first, and I want to see if I'm able to actually go over and switch to the screen share. Nope, it's not letting me do that. So I was going to actually walk through a live example of doing this so that you could see me do it at the same time. So I could actually shut down and restart the broadcast, but what I'll do is I'll just explain the process and some of the strategies. And then what I'll do is I'll do a separate screen share later that I'll tack on in a link to the process. So basically, when you go to do a Facebook post, and this could be on your personal account or on your business page, it gives you the opportunity to create a photo album. And there's a few reasons a photo album is a good idea. One, as I mentioned, because it gives you a way to tell a story, to show a series, to show progress, befores and afters, steps in a process, all kinds of things. And it also is a great way to categorize things by content themes. So I know that Sarah, who asked this question, owns her own Rodan and Fields business. And so for her, it could be a great opportunity for, one example might be to show the steps in a process of a product application. Or perhaps she's hosting an event and she wants to show sort of the steps and the process along the way and people's reactions and how they're using products and what those products look like. Or perhaps there's a package of products and she wants to show each step, each product, how it relates to the next. Now, the example I was going to show you was of my boyfriend, Peter, who is a contractor. And for him, this could also be a great example in showing the process of the evolution of a rehab or the creation. So what it looks like before, during, and after the process. Now, in setting that up, there is a button on the screen. You'll see on towards the left side, the other direction this way, that says hide from newsfeed. And this is that little sneaky feature that most of us never see, that if you click that button before you hit post to your album, it's going to prevent it from going by in the newsfeed. And why would you want to do that? As I said, maybe you want to get it set up. Maybe you want to see the landscape of your photos before you share it. And also, if you share that post on the newsfeed, or if you share that album on the newsfeed, it's going to take with it the definition of the photo album, which could be fine with you. But for many people, what they want to do is instead craft a different message to put it in a different context in the moment they're sharing it on Facebook. So what I recommend you do in that case is create the album. You'll place all your pictures into that album. You can drag and drop those photos so that you show the specific sequence of images you want it to showcase when that post goes live. But if you want to craft your message separately, Or perhaps you're in process and you want to add more photos to that album before you share it publicly, you can click that little button that says hide from newsfeed. So, oh, here we go again. Animals. They're very excited about Facebook photo albums. Anyway, you can click that button that says hide from newsfeed. Go ahead and post that album, and it won't show up in the newsfeed of the people that follow your page yet. Now, it will show up on your timeline. So what that means is it's still going to create the post, but it will be isolated to your page. So if you don't want that also to yet show up on your page, you can go to the top right corner of that post, click hide from timeline, and it will remove that as well. So this allows you to create your album, not have it yet make an impact on the newsfeed. You can then hide it from your page until you're ready to craft that very specific message about what that album is about, and make sure that you have all those images ready and in the sequence that you want to use them in. So then, once that album is set there, you can later go to that album, click share, and share that on your business page with more of a specific context and narrative that you want to put behind it. The other cool thing about having your album set up on Facebook is that you can also take those URLs and share them separately. So you might share it on Twitter. You might share it on your LinkedIn profile. You may put it into your email newsletter where you discuss what you have outlined to show people. And then those are all opportunities for links across the internet where other people can then find your Facebook page and like it. So it gives you a great opportunity for repurpose and reuse of content across different social channels that you can also then frame with different context based on the audience that you're targeting. So thank you so much for that great question, Sarah. I know I've experienced a lot of frustration sometimes in creating photo albums and hitting post before I'm ready. So knowing that that hide from newsfeed feature is available to you is a great way to set things up and then craft just that perfect message that you want to use when you're ready for it to go out live to the public. And then again, make sure that you keep an eye on that and reuse that across other social channels to gain that audience and drive that traffic over to your Facebook page. So like I said, I'm going to also go through a screen share example so that you can see the process where that little button is. And I will go ahead and also share that in the link between or below this Facebook Live. So I'm going to keep doing these Q&As every Friday, maybe at different times. The next 2 weeks will also be at 11:30 Central Time, but depending on my schedule, maybe at different times. And you may hear the dogs bark, but that's all part of the fun as well. Maybe I'll get them involved some way, somehow, sometime as well. All right. Thank you so much. And any questions you have, please drop in the comments or shoot me an email at sue@suekoch.com. Thanks. Bye-bye.